Hello, world. My name is Luke Thomas. I am the senior editor of MMAfighting.com. What you're about to watch is a tremendous video by BJJ Scout on some of the things that Dominick Cruz does in the most innovative ways with his footwork as we prepare for Dominick Cruz versus TJ Dillashaw here very soon. So a lot to learn here. This is a fantastic video, and you'll notice there are some audio clips of Dominick Cruz talking. That's from an interview I did with him strictly about his footwork in a series I do for the site on MMA Fighting called Technique Talk. There was a while there in MMA where a lot of people were complimenting the footwork of Dominick Cruz. Some people were actually criticizing it, but there was just a lot unknown about it. And for those who were criticizing it, I never bought their criticism, but even as someone who was sympathetic to what he was doing, it wasn't altogether clear what was happening. So I decided to talk to the guy myself eventually, and BJJ Scout put together this tremendous video here that marries some of the things he told me with, of course, his own brilliant analysis, both Dominick's and BJJ Scout. So check this out. I hope you enjoy it. If you get a chance, check out my interview as well. I'd really appreciate that. Thanks to BJJ Scout for including it, and can't wait for Cruz versus Dillashaw. It should be amazing. Check this video out.
You know, a lot of guys have footwork, but I really think that it's something that has been kind of forgotten. It's kind of a forgotten thing. It's not a must, but this is one of those things that I truly believe that the evolution of the sport will involve better footwork.
Everything is so beautiful and lovely and alive. You shouldn't say anything about anything not being.
You don't want to sit still in mixed martial arts, you'll get taken down. You have to be able to switch your feet because you have to be able to hit odd angles because people are coming at you from every position that's never been studied ever. It might look like I'm just hopping around doing all kinds of stuff, but they're actually like 6 to 10 different patterns that I follow over and over that create a style and create a movement and set up punches in certain areas depending on who I'm fighting. So depending on who I'm fighting, I can switch every pattern that I make with my feet. So what I'm trying to say is everybody moves forward and back. Nobody moves side to side in a fight. I like to make my defense and my offense mix and look the same. When I enter with my footwork, I'm also entering on a weak side so that I'm not taking damage when I decide to be offensive. And I'm also taking my head off the center line to do the same. So everything comes off of faith. And sometimes I throw on that in out, and sometimes I don't throw when I go, when I move in and out. Now the fighter doesn't know whether they want to counter me or wait for me to punch. When you do that, you put guesses in their head. Just stand there, and he's going to up his offense on you. If you do counter and you decide to throw on him, he's going to counter you and take you down. Or he's going to see what you throw, stay away from danger, and come up with new offense according to how you're adjusting to him. Figured out with footwork, it's so difficult for people to understand, is in order for footwork to be effective, you have to know what the other person's coming with next. That way you can move your feet in the right direction, in the right place to set them up for whatever you want to set them up for.
I don't think he's necessarily the best athlete, even maybe in that division, certainly not in the UFC. He might have the highest fight IQ of anybody. Like, this is a guy who can absolutely break down offenses and defenses. That's what Dominick Cruz does. He just looks at your game and he audits it. And my God, he will find your weakness quickly and I think exploit it.
Makes you wait for it.